Everybody who thinks new trucks are too expensive need to watch this video. My specific truck, which is a 2017 King Ranch F450, is a very expensive truck. It is over $80,000. However, when people watch videos about trucks like this, they often say trucks are too expensive nowadays, which they can be very expensive. In the case of my truck, it's probably at the higher level of truck cost that you'd be able to find. That being said though, a lot of folks don't realize that this is not the trim package you have to buy if you're gonna buy a new modern pickup truck. Let's talk about that. So I decided to visit the big three manufacturers of full-size pickup trucks in the US. I went to Ford, Chevrolet, and Ram's website, and I wanted to build trucks that I felt most people would want to buy with features that they would want in a new pickup truck, but at a price point that was well below $50,000. Now, the one thing I wanted to do is keep all the trucks the same in terms of configuration. So I chose crew cab, 8-foot bed, dually 4x4 configurations for all the trucks with gas engines. Reason I opted for gas engines is because if you look at the power, the towing capacity of these new trucks with gas engines, they rival those of diesel trucks from just 10 to 15 years ago. So if you're looking to upgrade from, say, a 7.3 diesel back in the early 2000s to a new gas engine, you can easily do that and retain the same payload and towing capacity that you might have had with your diesel. Now, the things I wanted to add to these trucks, starting with Ford, were features that I felt people would want in a new truck if you're going to be paying the money for it. Things that don't cost too much more but can save you a lot of money in the long run, such as the camper package, which gives you the upgraded front suspension, the upgraded rear suspension with stabilizer bars, things like that. The chrome appearance package with Ford is the STX package, which gives you a chrome grille, chrome bumpers. I added the 430 rear gear ratio, which is going to give you the 16,500 pound maximum tow capacity of the dually gas engine truck. Did the 360 degree cameras, upfitter switches, added the puck system for the fifth wheel gooseneck prep. Just basically all the features that I really thought people would like, including Sync 3, which gives you that 8-inch touchscreen display, Bluetooth, all of that cool stuff. And that works with the camera system as well, so you can use it with 360-degree cameras. Changed from vinyl to cloth seats. When everything was said and done, we were able to get this truck right at the $48,000 mark. And this truck, with rebates and discounts and all of that, you could probably get down to about $42,000 if you were going to buy it, which I think is a heck of a deal on a truck like this. I think most people wouldn't imagine that they could get a truck with that much stuff, including all the cameras and everything, for about $47,355. But then again, you can probably negotiate another $6,000, $6,500 off of that, get the truck around the $42,000 mark, and have a really awesome truck. Now let's move on to Chevrolet. So the Chevy trucks are a little bit less expensive. You're going to be able to build out a truck. It's not going to have quite the technology features simply because Chevrolet doesn't offer a lot of the technology features yet. So just like the Ford, we started with a crew cab 3500 HD four-wheel drive truck. We opted for the Vortec 6.0 liter V8 gas engine again. This specific truck, we decided to go with the red metallic, just to change things up a little bit. So we did the convenience package, which is a pretty significant upgrade. It comes with quite a bit of things, including remote keyless entry, locking tailgate, rear camera, basically all the convenience features that you might want. Now, this specific truck does not have a 360-degree camera option available to it unless we go to the highest equipped package like an LTZ or a High Country. We got a lot of the features that we figured people would want, such as the bed LED lights, spray and bed liner, things like that. Stuff that a lot of folks would probably want in a truck if they got a brand new truck. We got XM satellite radio, remote keyless entry. We got the four upfitter switches, which are also currently available as an option. And we have the package, of course, that includes a rear camera. So this specific truck, when everything was said and done, was right at $47,000. After the discounts that they have available, it was $46,000. I still think you could probably get an additional $6,000 off of that price. So you're looking at a truck around $41,000. So with the Vortec 6-liter gas engine, you're going to have about a 14,500-pound conventional tow rating and a 14,600-pound fifth-wheel tow rating, which are pretty good ratings for a gas-powered truck. And again, there's a lot of fifth wheels, including my fifth wheel, that has a gross vehicle weight rating of 14,000 pounds, so technically this truck would be more than adequate for towing it. So moving on to Ram trucks. Now, Ram trucks, to me, are kind of considered the value segment of trucks in this category, and even when you're looking at diesel trucks, mainly because you have so many different configurations you can get the truck in. In this specific case, we opted for a Tradesman Edition truck. We got some of the appearance packages on it as well. We did it in four-wheel drive configuration, crew cab, long wheelbase with the dually package. Now, Ram's site is a little bit more difficult to navigate because you can't actually select a dually from the starting page. You have to go through and you have to go about three tabs in before you opt for dual rear wheels. And that changes a lot of things. So again, it's just a little bit more cumbersome to navigate. Anyways, we opted for the larger of the two Hemis, the 6.4 liter Hemi. We also opted for the 410 gear ratio in the back, which is going to give us the maximum tow rating of this specific truck. Now, something that was kind of surprising to me was that the 2018 Ram 3500 dually with the 6.4 liter Hemi V8, which is the largest gas V8 of any of these, actually had the lowest towing capacity. It was only 12,100 pounds, and that's for a dually configured crew cab truck. Now, I figured it would probably be in the 14,000-15,000 pound range. Now, it does have a tremendous payload capacity, so it has 6,670 pounds worth of payload capacity, but again, the maximum towing capacity is 12,100 pounds. You would be hard-pressed to find a fifth wheel that falls in that weight range unless it's a very, very small half-ton towable fifth wheel. However, this truck would be great for hauling a large travel trailer, and if you can find a small fifth wheel, it's definitely going to give you the rear suspension capable of hauling it. So this isn't a bad choice as long as you're a little careful with what type of trailer you're going to be hauling with it. As I was saying earlier, you can see on this screen where you have to opt for the dually configuration. We also went with the chrome package on it, which gives us the chrome grille and the chrome bumper. Did the LED bed light system on this, as well as the fifth wheel gooseneck prep package, which again is just kind of a no-brainer if you're going to be hauling a fifth wheel or travel trailer or a possible gooseneck trailer with these trucks, to have that hitch system already built in. I also opted for the Uconnect system on this truck. That way you have kind of an infotainment system versus just the standard radio in the truck. It gives you touchscreen, Bluetooth, and several other features that just make the truck a little bit more enjoyable to drive. I included the upfitter switch option that Ram also has, as well as the backup camera and the rear parking sensors and the trailer brake control. Now, this specific truck came in much lower than the other trucks, about $7,000 to $8,000 lower than the other trucks, even considering you're getting all these options with it. So one thing you may want to consider if you're looking at a Ram truck is to go ahead and get the Cummins upgrade. That way you get a diesel truck, and with all the rebates and discounts that Ram generally offers, generally between $8,000 and $12,000, you can probably get into a Tradesman Edition with the diesel engine plus all these features for about the same price, or even in some cases slightly lower than the gas-equipped engines from both Chevrolet and Ford, making this by far the best value of any of the HD trucks. So I hope this video was helpful. I hope it kind of clarified some of the points that I make, that you don't have to get the most expensive version of every truck that's out there on the market. Oftentimes you can spec out and build a truck exactly the way you want it, with a lot of the newer features that you would expect in a new truck, but at a price point that's far, far, far closer to what your budget may be. Shoot, you can even build some of these trucks, if you're not interested in a dually, all the way down to the $29,000, $32,000 price range, which is really a good deal considering just how expensive all cars are nowadays. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment field below. If you haven't had a chance, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and I will talk to you guys next time. Thanks, everyone.